كل العالم.
And this is the
most important food for building this function and those children. The lower mean effect is tied to the lower GRD effect as both have the same embryological function and up to 6 weeks of gestation, both embryological cells and lion blood open into common providers. Also, as you see here, that if the abdomen is distinguished with the blood fetal mother, this may compress the blood vein and leading to the other dysfunction. This is the normal stool, soft stool, associated with normal females, pumped females. While women develop this hard stool, the soft stool above it leads around the hard stool, leading to fecal soiling of the underground, which is called encolisis. So, now the fecal production may be used to cause an instability. That is what is called dysfunction elimination syndrome. The main dysfunction elimination syndrome is that dysfunction of one, either the lower or the other, may affect the other. There are two main types of dysfunction elimination syndrome. Disorder of pain, which is associated with overactive blood and associated with fecal infection and fecal extension. Dysfunction of eating, which is associated with overactive pelvic flow during voiding. And this also leads mainly to non-relaxation of the pubic pelvis and painful defecation. So, this dysfunction of patients in the world when present, usually associated with multiple urinary problems, as very little reflux, UTI, and infertility. So, dysfunction elimination syndrome should be treated first before production of these urologic problems. Then, the bladder sphincter dysfunction during the bladder filling, as we said, in the form of active bladder. That means overactive bladder means sudden severe desire to micturate that is difficult to digest. May be associated with or without urgent incontinence. This is called urgent incontinence, which is more common in females and often those children seen with more malnourished. That includes Vincent Kennedy as this picture of holding maneuver, and lastly, those children have open to be in his collecting position with the heel in the urinary. Functional urinary incontinence, which means involuntary loss of urine due to failure of control of the bladder sphincter of events. The amount of leakage in those children is usually very small, and this condition often seen in older girls than play sports. And it is simply disease and often disappear at the age of puberty. Gigil incontinence. The cause of gigil incontinence, which means incontinence during giggling or laughing, is unknown. The actual cause is unknown. And during giggling, large volume of urine may leak and may empty the bladder. Why bladder sphincter dysfunction during the bladder drinking have nearly five problems. Either staccato voiding, which means bursts of pelvic floor activity during voiding, leading to interrupted urine and high liver out. And this is the blockage of staccato voiding. Interrupting stream. Why vaginal voiding? Which is due to the causal activity that lead to infrequent and complete painting of the bladder. And the blockage in this children has originated from reaching to the red line, then reaching to the tumors, then reaching to the red line again. And those children may be seen with picture of overflow incontinence. There is a bladder syndrome, which is a modest form of voiding dysfunction Because what as we see here, large bubble, we have large, we have large and thick bubble, both the frequent voiding and both joints to me. And the abdominal strain should be elicited to minimize the rubber. And this is the modest form of voiding dysfunction. The severe form of voiding dysfunction, which is known as the Henle syndrome, or the other term, non-neurogenic, neurogenic rubber, have the picture of neuromassive rubber, but in absence of any neurogenic disorder. Those children have overactive mental load and symptoms, severe form of voiding dysfunction, and often have overflowing confidence, and often get hard UTR and recover UTR. And about 2/3 of these children have associated thyroid disorders. And as we see in the picture, reflux is a common association in nearly one of zero resource patients. While the other form is Schwoba syndrome, which is chromosomal recessive inherited disorder, with origin in chromosome 10, those children, as you see here in the picture, have dysfunction voiding and ventral crying secretion, as seen here, with smiling. And those children, one half of them may be presented with end stage kidney disease. The fifth letter of dysfunction during the mother lactation is the post-voiding period, which is common in children. Usually, this is vaginal leakage due to pediatric allergy. And often diagnosed with the refugee. And for treatment of this case, we should encourage girls to boiling with size above and with opening of the labia during voiding. So, when you face a case of voiding dysfunction, there are important products for evaluation of those patients. Often those children present after 20 treatment, except if there is associated urinary tract infection or associated reflux can be diagnosed from the age of 20 training, which is 4 years old. By history taking, we should exclude indicate, we should hold out the symptoms of neurologic abnormalities as painful urination or misurination and deny it of vaginal pain and discharge. Medical and surgical risk, of course, is important, including blood pressure, include the renal discovery from associated reflux, which is common in those children. Voiding denial and regarding the storage and voiding and frequency is important also to diagnose those cases. Also, bowel history is important. And in most cases of voiding dysfunction, the family history regarding the bowel habits is very poor. And you should know and ask them for the associated symptoms of investigation or diseases or whatever would have as a cause of voiding dysfunction, which is the most common cause. During the examination, general with the gait and movement of the child, abdominal examination towards to as the bladder may be bulk of this heart, give out of its wrist, bulk of the fecal, back to fecal matter of the nose. Back examination of the heart, which is a very important to exclude your underlying neurological disease. The back examination is very important in those children. As you see here, this has a meeting of the nutrient lens, this one lens, and the other time, the lens group lens. And this may be a sign of underlying spinal cord disease. The other is haircut on the left. Also, the is hidden underlying neurological disease. Also, the meaning at the back may be associated with underlying neurological disease. So, back examination in the patient with voiding dysfunction is really crucial. Examination of the external genome. As we said before, most voiding development in the maybe little bigger than me. So examination of the labia of the lung children is important to explore labia lesion, and this may be the cause of this volume dysfunction. Why in boys it is very important to note in the list associated neonatal stenosis to them. Neonatal stenosis is the very common cause in children in boys with volume dysfunction. Also to assess the state of circumcision and in the list associated stenosis. Regarding the broad investigation, urine analysis to exclude bacteriuria and protozoa or bacteria, serum and urinary osmolality in presence of bacteria and disease. Imaging studies by ultrasound to assess the alert rate and the thickness of the blood wall and the liver out. This usually is important to rule out red flags and give us idea about the capacity of the bladder and if there is associated bladder wall regularity, and this is important in diabetes with voiding dysfunction, to know that there is what is called the spinal tubular whisker. As you see here, there is part of bladder called ball contraction at the bladder wall. Then there is manual tapering of the whisker, which is the sign of the bladder, which is the sign of voiding dysfunction. Also to assess the liver out and the most important event. Then it's a rate of the MRI is only needed in the list of patients of undergoing neurological support. Urodynamic usually not indicated unless there is resistance to treatment with resistance to avoiding dysfunction. And these are the normal values of hemodynamic evaluation shape. So, when you face a case of voiding dysfunction with exclusion of neurovascular element, there are several lines to treatment. But the aim of treatment is to protect the upper tract, improve the lower tract function, improvement of urinary incontinence, and improvement of patient's quality of life. So, parents will start with behavioral modification and the standard yourself, which include lower training and voiding level, which is very important to know the voiding dynamics of the children and to know the volume of voiding urine and the frequency of voiding, which is very important in those children. As there may be invasive bladder syndrome, the voiding being over the 24-hour diabetes and sleep weights per day, and this may be a sign of lesion levels of water or infrequent voiding in those children. So it is also important to educate the parents about the disease, and it is usually simply looking at this bucket required some rehabilitation of the family and the child. Changing the low bucket, which is important for having addictive medical dialogue, which is important to maintain the levels of school. Then we develop muscle training and body feedback, which is not the first line of treatment, but it is important that it means the self-conception of mucosal contraction and the level of low relaxation. As we said before, the level is the most common cause of constipation, is the most common one of the most common causes of body dysfunction. So, those children may need regular treatments for maintaining the regular soft tissue and maintaining the regular soft tissue by adequate medical treatments. Medication needed, which is mostly anticholinergic, in severe cases, after failure of behavioral medication, we may add anticholinergic, which is an oxygen in the gold standard of those children for overactive bladder. Also newly important drugs like neuroprotectant, which is the vasomimetic beta-3 amines, acting on the overactive bladder, but it is more than developed in children less than 10 years. Alpha-adrenergic drugs may be needed if there is evidence of bladder neck dysfunction or hyperactive bladder neck. Tricyclic antidepressant may be used
ريزولوش كذلك ان هذا سيجنتشر از انتي كولينرج تي اي سي از وين فور ذا ليز بابل سيندروم او انتورك اند بويلرز ميني بويلر ليز ذا سي فاينس ان 24 اور مين ستيم ستيم ذا بويلر فور مور ذان 12 اور جوست شيلدر ميني the grids of other with clean permitted stabilization every 4 hours. Also, this CIC may allow for global cleaning and improve the mucosal integrity by removal of evacuating the blood and regaining the blood integrity in the improvement of lastly, surgery is not indicated in cases of body dysfunction unlike the classic blood. This implemented through augmentation cystoblastic with observed outlet in cases of severe problem which is the Henderson syndrome which is non-neurogenic neurogenic dysfunction problem is less of hard poison depression that means that the rates are so this is a summary of the approach to avoiding dysfunction. In a child with suspected voiding dysfunction and maintains this mistake has working and recovered 25 or anxiety related to results, we should hold out organic pathology by gastric physical examination, urine analysis and ultrasound BCG. If we hold out inorganic growth, we can maintain the child contamination level, voiding and voiding the level. With treatment of constipation and related complexity, there is associated with loss and if there is associated with loss and if there is improvement, we can pull them up. If there is no improvement and if there is a resistance, we can